Well, here we are in the drive-thru line. Me and her. Cars in front of us, cars in back of us, all just waiting to order. There's some idiot in a Volvo with his brights on behind me. I lean out the window and scream, hey, what you trying to do, blind me? My wife says maybe we should park, we could just go eat inside. I said I'm wearing bunny slippers, so I ain't leaving this ride. Now a woman on a speaker box is saying, can I take your order, please? I said, yes, indeed, you certainly can. We'd like two hamburgers with onions and cheese. Then my wife says, baby, hold on, I've changed my mind. I think I'm gonna have a chicken sandwich instead this time. I said, you always get a cheeseburger. She says, that's not what I'm hungry for. I put my head in my hands and scream, I don't know who you are anymore. The voice on the speaker says, I don't have all day. I said, then take her order, and we'll be on our way. I wanna get a chicken sandwich, and I want a cheeseburger too. She's like, you want onions on that? I'm like, yeah, I already said that I do. Plus we need curly fries, and don't you dare forget it. And two medium root beers, no, just one, we'll split it. Then I said, I'm guessing that you're probably not too bright. So read me back my order, let's make sure you got it right. She says, one, you want a chicken sandwich? Two, you want a cheeseburger? Three, curly fries and a large root beer? Stop, don't go no further. I never ordered a large root beer, I said medium, not large. Then she says, we're having a specialized supersized you at no charge. Oh, oh. And that's all I could say was, oh, oh. And she says, now there's something else that I really think you should know. You can have unlimited refills for just a quarter more. I say, great, except we're in the drive-thru. So what would I want that for? But she says, wait a minute. Your voice sounds so familiar. Hey, is this Paul? And my wife is all like, no, that ain't Paul. Now tell me, who's this Paul? She says, oh, he's just some guy who goes to school with me. I sat behind him last year and I copied off of him in geometry. I said, I know a guy named Paul. He used to be my plumber. He was prematurely bald. Then he moved to Pittsburgh last summer. He also had bladder problems and a really bad infection on his toe. And she says, mister, please, you can stop right there. That's way more than I needed to know. And then we both were quiet, and things got real intense. And then she says, next window, please, that'll be $5.82. So we inched ahead in line, moving painfully slow. I got a little bored, so I turned on the radio. Off because my wife was getting a headache. So we both just sat there quietly for her sake. Well, then I looked at her, and she looked back at me. And I said, I think you have something in your teeth. She turned away from me, and then turned back and said, did I get it? I said, yeah, well, I mean, most of it, but hey, you know, don't sweat it. Then she said, still a little bit there, but don't worry. It's probably just a piece of toast. Now we're at the bay window, or whatever you call it. Put my hand in my pocket. I can't believe there's no wallet.